Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me this afternoon is James Passin, CEO at BioVaxys Technology. James, good to see you. How are you?
Fantastic. Great to see you again.
Yeah, an exciting day for you, James. As from my understanding, the group has received findings back that it shows BioVaxys' vaccine may not lead to some of the side effects associated that we do see with the current approved mRNA vaccines. So share more details with us there.
So we've just gotten back a report from Millipore Sigma, which is the U.S. subsidiary of Merck KGaA, the German pharmaceutical giant. Millipore Sigma did an experiment for us with an assay that they have developed. And the purpose of this experiment was to test the bindability of the haptenized spike protein, which is what is in our vaccine for COVID, to the regular spike protein as the control arm. And what is extraordinarily encouraging about this experiment is that there's been, in the words of our partners at Millipore Sigma, a complete inhibition of the bindability of the spike protein. In other words, the haptenized spike protein, which is basically what's in our vaccine, it's unable to bind to the ACE2 receptor, but we are able to induce immunity against the unhaptenized spike protein. And this really is what is exciting, not only for this particular product, BVX-0320, our COVID vaccine candidate, but our class of vaccines more generally. Based on numerous studies, peer-reviewed publication, literature, or the data that's coming out, you know, the vaccines from either the COVID vaccines, whether it's mRNA or adenovirus vector vaccine, those vaccines can, in some cases, albeit rare, there are some very serious side effects, whether it's myocarditis, blood clotting. Apparently there are even women having effect on their periods. All of these side effects, however rare they are, one way or the other, are related to the spike protein binding to the ACE2 receptor. And so if it's possible to induce immunity to the spike protein in a way that is not binding to the ACE2 receptor, then this is gonna may prove to be an extraordinarily important not only technological breakthrough, but strategy for dealing with COVID variants.
Yeah, how so? Because we are seeing the Omicron variant kind of cresting right now. So are you betting on more variants emerging and, us, the public potentially getting more booster shots?
Well, we think it's inevitable that there will be variants that will have some level of immune escape. In next winter, I'm sure there's going to be some version of COVID coming back. Now, it is the case that Omicron generally is a fairly mild form of COVID, generally not getting into the lungs, and is inducing immunity that's cross-reactive with other variants, which is quite positive from the point of view of global public health. So hopefully COVID will go away, but my guess is that it will remain. And if there does need to be strategies for continuing herd immunity, I mean, one of the strategies will have to be boosters. But if you're going to have wide scale mandates or inducements or whatever for booster take up, why not construct a vaccine in which the side effects related to the spike protein binding to the ACE2 receptor are eliminated? So in terms of our previous work, we've seen that our haptenized spike protein vaccine in an animal study, this is in mice, had a 96.4% efficacy for antibodies. We saw the full suite of T cells that you want to see after an effective vaccination. The Ohio State University observed a neutralizing antibody from the blood of our vaccinated mice against live SARS-CoV-2 coronavirus. And of the 56 vaccinated mice, there were no side effects. Now, of course, that's in mice, that's not in human, but this new report with the humanized ACE2 receptor assay from Millipore Sigma is very encouraging. And really, this is pointing the way to the planned study, which we're expecting in April, from our partner, the Ohio State University. Ohio State is doing, they have a world-recognized SARS and experts, and they've got a BL3 lab, and they're going to do an experiment with what we call our pan-Sorbeco virus vaccine, which is based on haptenizing not only the spike protein from COVID, but the spike protein from the original SARS pandemic in 2003, and sort of doing a combo. And what we are expecting is that this will produce pan-Sorbeco virus neutralizing antibodies. And they're going to test against four different Sorbeco viruses. So if that experiment is successful, it'll be very exciting, because that pan-Sorbeco virus immunity potentially would not only provide immunity against all COVID variants, but against other Sorbeco viruses that you know are potentially lurking in bat caves or in laboratories or wherever. So we're excited about being able to do the experiment to test our pan-Sorbeco virus vaccine, but on the backbone of what we know now, which is that the haptenized spike protein is safe. For us, this is really, really exciting, and we're very proud to move forward with our vaccine platform, which is clearly based on sound science.
Well, congrats on this latest data here, James. We'll look forward to following the story here. Thanks so much.
Thank you. My pleasure.